The Cincinnati Initiative to Reduce Violence is a high-stakes investment, a program meant to save lives that some city leaders now say isn't worth the money.
The dreams of another family broken.
That was the worst day of my life. Worst day of my life.
Carmen Famble's son Rio was gunned down July 25th in Over the Rhine, and her nightmare only got worse when those closest to her son threatened to seek revenge.
I was trying to keep the peace, telling his friends and family members that we didn't want no more violence, even though my son died a tragic death.
So the Cincinnati Initiative to Reduce Violence stepped in to prevent more shooting.
We just intervened and said somewhere down the line, enough is enough. We've got to stop. This cycle of violence has got to stop.
But some city leaders, including Councilmember Leslie Giz, now question whether CIRV has stopped enough violence to justify its nearly $900,000 a year price tag.
That $900,000 for CIRV would have stopped the brownouts that we have going on in the fire department right now.
So where is all that money going? Well, the biggest chunk of CIRV's funding, almost $500,000, is being used on salaries for CIRV staff. Most have the title street advocate. They get paid between $31,000 and $35,000 a year with benefits to help rehabilitate career criminals who have entered the program. The street advocates turn in template timesheets like these with no real accounting of how they spend their time. But project manager Stan Ross says the street advocates are on call virtually 24/7, responding to murder scenes, organizing Stop the Violence rallies, making court appearances, and helping ex-offenders find jobs.
Our time is all over the place. It would be an oddity nightmare to try to keep up with every hour that we spend out here.
At least part of every week for the street advocates is also spent in training sessions like this one, learning ways to earn the trust of ex-offenders and convince them to give up a life of crime.
The thing is to look at those individuals in regards to how we've been able to impact their lives.
CIRV's impact on violence in Cincinnati has been up and down. Homicides actually rose in the program's first year, although research funded by the CIRV program says murder among gangs, its target group, is down 35% in the past 2 years. And CIRV says there's been an 11% drop in overall shooting so far this year. But Councilwoman Leslie Giz is not convinced.
That's not good enough for me. I'm not willing to pay that kind of a price to try to weed out one bad person. I would much rather have boots on the street in the form of police officers.
But Stan Ross says police officers cannot replace what CIRV is doing.
When you talk to people who we have touched, when you talk to groups that we have touched, you will never be able to compare money to these people's lives.
People like Carmen Famble, who, after her son's murder, had seen enough violence.
I just wanted peace, and I just wanted peace.
And, at least for now, CIRV has been able to give her that.
For the around $900,000 price tag, CIRV reaches about 200 ex-offenders. They say they would like to reach more people, but they don't have the money. I'm Eric Flack, News 5.